My mom gave me the greatest gift. When I was 3 and a half, she started teaching me how to play piano. And you may be wondering, what the heck does this have to do with John Lennon, Eric? Are you about to tell me where you were when John Lennon was shot? The thing is, I don't know. I was 7, we were trying to escape Soviet Russia. That was actually another really nice gift that my parents gave me, was getting us the heck out of Soviet Russia, which does wind up being related to this song. But more importantly, my mom taught me music, and that resulted in my teaching myself how to play guitar later in life. And once I kind of learned basic chords, I went on to the bar chords, G, H, C, and then I started getting bored with those, and I started thinking, all right, what else is out there? And there's this cool like little seventh chord up there, and F7, and then there's this little weird way to play a D7, and I was just working my way up all the things you could do around this G chord, like this sus chord here, and then the coolest thing happened. Check out this chord that I invented. I totally made that up, and I was like, that's kind of an interesting sounding chord. I could use that somewhere. And I was like, I'll bury it in the chorus of a song I'm going to write, just kind of in an unimportant place. So, anyway, song 1 of 2 that has something to do with John Lennon. My parents came from a land of ice and snow in AK-47s. Settled down in Chicago in a four-room place in Rogers Park. Teacher said for Halloween we could dress up like our favorite heroes. I was the only kid in the second grade who looked like Joseph Stalin that day. Teacher asked me why I didn't. I looked down and I admitted I'm an immigrant. I didn't know. In college, I tried flirting with an older girl named Julie Bell. She was nearly 21 with abs of steel and thighs of milk and perfect grades. One day after chemistry, she invited me upstairs for coffee. Drink that stuff, and I saddled up my bike and rode away. Sadly, a true story. Roommate asked me why I did it. I looked down and I admitted I'm an immigrant. I didn't know. A boy is easily confused in a land that's filled with double V's when W is what the natives say. Woe to the boy who's lost when W and O are crossed, and women work in wonder bras, and woolly wolves and wobbly cars, all sorts of difference, written all the same. In the land of AK-47s, leaders change with generations. In '88, the news announcer said we'd pick George Herbert Walker Bush. The only president I'd ever known was rapping Ronnie Reagan. My civics teacher asked the class, why is it good to change the president? The teacher asked me, don't you get it? I looked around and I admitted I'm an immigrant. I didn't know. I'm an immigrant.
Thank you.